This timer on the hunt today. Should have seen the look of pride on his face.
Long Notch is well stocked, as you asked.
And our scouts are watching for more Frostclaws.
Our numbers rise. 3 more hunters have passed their trials. But our purpose was to take back the mountain. Now what?
Stay prepared. Sharpen your spears. Should we not return, defending the cut falls to you. If our chieftain agrees with this course.
Sounds like good advice, but let's hope it doesn't come to that.
Chieftain?
The weight of command is no small burden.
I can see that. I take it you haven't spoken to Araya yet?
Why should I? This is what she wanted, to return to Thunder's Drum. It is her only care. So I should have known she would find a way to push aside my spear. After the Karja took my sister, not all of her came back.
What happened to Araya when she was a captive of the Karja?
As a shaman, she's adept with machines, tracking them, stunning them. The Karja used her to capture them for the Sunring, where they were unleashed upon the innocent. They made her part of their blood sport. The shame she suffered beneath their pitiless sun.
She survived.
She endured. Endured by reminding herself of the spirit, her purpose. And now that's all she has.
For what it's worth, I'm glad you're coming with me.
Someone has to keep Araya safe.
That's what's been called, and punishment is in progress. Now, don't live your life for the sake of your song. Your song will come on its own.
Aloy, this is it. My chance to reunite with the spirit, and perhaps to reunite her with the blue light. It's not a chance I would have had alone. I needed an outsider. Someone ignorant of our ways, but no, not ignorant.
Are you trying to thank me, Araya?
Yes, of course. That's what you do. Untangle knots. Create possibilities. Thank you for making this pilgrimage possible. I only wish it had not been necessary to humiliate Aratak. You were wise to let him come. He's earned the right. Stubborn as stone, but he's had to be. The war demanded it. And so have I.
Aratak told me you were a captive of the Karja for a long time. It sounded bad.
For Aratak, it all comes back to that. He thinks the Karja changed me. They did not. They merely sharpened my focus. When all else is lost, you think about what's truly important. The spirit. The blue light. The beyond. And my brother, too. Every time I felt the chill northern wind, I thought of him, worried for him.
What did the war do to Aratak?
He cut away everything, until only his true self remained. Unyielding ice. No Banuk has more sheer will. He fought the Karja for 1,000 freezing nights, yet always rallied his hunters at sunrise. It is said he endured 23 wounds in those years. His hunters counted them. He never complains of one. Instead, he complains that life with me is harder. He's right. What have I ever given him but struggle?
Now that I'm chieftain of the Werak, I don't suppose I can order you to tell me about Silence?
Aratak would never have presumed to grasp for a secret of the Conclave, but you are not Aratak, and if you have dealt with Silence, your need is well apparent. Silence came to Banuk from the distant north, a young shaman of the Owl's Watch, a remote Werak that rarely comes south to parley.
Silence was a shaman.
He was. Or at least, when we sent runners to ask the Owl's Watch, they said he was. His knowledge of the machines was beyond compare, and he was hungry to trade what he knew to the rest of us. It didn't take him long to gain the trust of the Conclave, and eventually, an invitation to attend.
What about you? Did you trust him?
No. But he impressed me. He carried himself with poise and authority. I wanted to learn from him, but that was not to be. He was granted knowledge of our most sacred meeting place, the frozen caves of the Malmstrom, a month's march from Banuk. He met with us there, as is custom at high winter. But when we next returned, the caves had been looted. Relics of the old world stolen, holes cut in ice and metal.
Yeah, that'd be Silence, all right.
He vanished with the spoils. We sent our best trackers after him. None returned. And when we checked back with the Owl's Watch, those who had vouched for him were gone, as though he never existed. Some in the Conclave began to doubt he was even Banuk to begin with.
And what do you think?
He committed an unforgivable sacrilege. He's unscrupulous and dangerous, but also brilliant, skilled, and knowledgeable without equal. Except, perhaps, for you. Anyone else I would warn off, but you may be able to treat with him safely. Just don't lower your guard.
I'll keep that in mind, Horea. Thanks. What are we gonna find up there, Horea?
Ruins. Machines. And a door, like that of a cauldron. I have faith that you can find a way through it, Aloy. For beyond it lies the spirit. I know I can find her there. Though I do not doubt the daemon has tried to hide the way.
It hasn't been easy for you, Aurea, getting back to this point.
It was all to hear her voice again. This time, we both will.
I'd like that.
Are you ready then, once we ascend? It will be hard to turn back. Finally, we ascend.
How? I don't see a way up.
Not up. Through.
No, brother!
Please remain calm and
So you see, I too can call upon the power of the old ones. What was this place?
The spirit once told me that this all used to be part of its domain. A fortress that defended humankind from terrible danger.
Fortress? It looks more like a machine.
Is that not fitting? The blue light often dwells in machines.
Let's just hope that some remains here. Here, up and over. Metal doors.
November 21st, 2064. It's been 3 years since I was last here, and 12 since I was running the place. Just a skeleton crew left, confused about why I'm here. So am I. Anita wants me to find a way to suspend operations for a while. Maybe a long while. And I don't know why. But from the sound of her voice, it was something terrifying. I wish I could look into her eyes, ask her what the hell she's so freaked out about, but what else is new? When don't I wish I could look into her eyes again?
Aloy? Were you listening for something?
There are memories here. Messages left by the old ones.
And you can hear them. I envy you. What did they say?
I'm not sure yet, Aloy. Machines. At least we have the drop on them.
Thank you.
space is measured, ours is measured.
Oh, useful.
We can make our way upwards when you're done.
Much farther now.
Last we were here, we fought our way through there. The machines overcame us. We retreated, dropping supplies and taking losses. Now we must prevail, with only two warriors and a shaman to protect.
Aloy is no ordinary warrior. But I can hold my own. Even so, I could go that way instead. There are machines up there, but also cover. We could stay hidden, at least for a while.
All right, I get the options. Follow my lead. Pipes, towers, steam, frost. What was all this for?
Ago, looking for cover in case machines came prowling. I have no doubt that it is guarded now, but we may be able to stay in. moving.
Be wary of mines. Stalkers are near.
I'll linger any longer than we have to.
Ha.
There's a door up ahead, and refuge. We're almost through.
Technically, I can't suspend the cooling system, but I can reduce the power draw so that it'll be completely masked by the caldera. But masked from what? Firebreak has always been confidential for security reasons, but this would be excessive. Even for the dear departed Mr. Blevins. What could possibly have gotten Anita so worked up?
Full already.